Hello and welcome to another stream. My name is Ray and it is Learning Korean Day 147. Thanks a lot for tuning in. So yesterday we finished the vocabulary of lesson 14. We did some reviewing, enough reviewing I would say. We did even like two extra sessions of reviewing. So today we will do, just to get into it, we will do one more review session and then we'll go into the grammar lesson on the website. So first of all, let's go to memorize here and do those 27 words. Let's go. Okay. Next year is Nenyon. And we have a spammer in the chat already. Goodbye. Well, okay. Nenyon is the correct answer.
Nenyon.
Okay. Driver. Unjonsa.
Unjonsa.
Unjonhada is to drive. Keep up the good work. Keep up the good work. Is this Sugo? Sugoada? Oh wait, this comes from the first course, so it's not a dictionary form. It's probably Sugo Heyo. Hayo. Haseyo.
Suguhaseyo.
There we go. This week. Iponju.
Iponju.
Iponju. It's good, I like. Okay. Again, no dictionary form. This is like a full sentence. It's good. It should be. Joyo.
Joyo.
To be turned off. Gojida.
Gojida.
Gojida. Yeah, immediately. Yep. We had it yesterday and again yesterday I said I will not remember it next time and today is next time. I don't know how should I remember this. It has like no connection to anything. Jixi, it's Jixi.
Jixi.
But still, it's super hard. What are you looking for? To look for something is chatta. It's bo chachayo. Bo chachayo. Okay, cash is Hyeongim, I think. Hyeongim. Hyeongimi. Opsoyo. Wow, I mistype so much. So is this correct? I think so. So yeah. I don't have cash. So this one is Cash, I think. Maybe it's Hyeongim and not Hyung. I said Hyeongim as well.
현금이 yeah. 없어요.
Okay, so this was one of the sentences that I now understand. And back when I learned it, I didn't understand. But now I know, okay, Hyeongim is probably cash. And then the E is the particle. And then the opsoyo is to not have. And I also know how it's translated, conjugated. So that's all the things that you can't know when you just see the sentence by itself. Okay, it's delicious. Mashisoyo.
맛있어요.
To be perfect. Perfectly is one Johnny, and this one should be one Byokada.
완벽하다.
To run. 빨리다. 뭘? This one. 달리다.
달리다.
Or is Kilse or something else? I have no idea. Okay, kill is here. Kill. Say is here. Yo is here. I don't know.
글쎄요.
Double S. See, I have no idea why this is the case. Like, what are these individual parts? I have no idea. So this is a useless sentence for me right now. Well, 글쎄요. It's not even a sentence, but yeah, it's just useless to learn. Usually, should be capchagi. Okay, it's not capchagi. What was capchagi then? Suddenly. Suddenly is capchagi. Usually. Potong? Potang? Let me see. Potong?
Potong.
Ah, wow. That's it. To be scared. 두렵다. 두렵다. 두렵다.
두렵다.
글쎄요.
글쎄요.
서다.
서다.
To drive. 운전하다.
운전하다.
To cook. 요리하다.
요리하다.
Plants. I think it's like
Kevin.
Wow. I did not expect it to be completely correct in the first try. A little. What do they mean a little? Is it like 지금? Jogum.
조금.
Jogum, yeah. To trick somebody. 속이다.
속이다.
Chef. Yorisa.
요리사.
Next month. 다음 달.
다음 달.
To impress. 감동하다.
감동하다.
다음 주. 아.
다음 주.
Office worker. 회사월? 회사원.
회사원.
Okay, yeah, it was pretty decent, I would say. 10 more. Yeah, okay, let's do the 10 more and then we go to the website. Fire is pull.
불.
Nada.
나다.
자꾸, I think 자꾸.
자꾸.
Yeah. To turn on, 켜다.
켜다.
Body. 몸.
몸.
열리다.
열리다.
약.
약.
약. To hide. What was to hide again? 오, I don't remember this one. To hide. Oh, I think it was the Zoom, right? Zoom da and Zoom Gida. I think Zoom Gida.
숨기다.
Wow, nice. Late. Okay, I know early. Ilgic. Late. Late, I have no idea. Na. Mu. Oh, this one seems familiar. Nütta.
늦다.
It's weird. Early, for example, is Ilgic. And late is a da. It has the da in the end. So there are clearly different kinds of words, early and late, which is weird. So I think the early I learned is just like a time specification, but this late is more like to be late. I think so. Hi China White, thanks for tuning in. I don't know yet. I have no idea. Well, BSL itself, you can always play in that. You know, there are three tiers of tournaments: the Pro League, the Gosu League, and the Chobo League. And even if you just play 20 games, you are always qualified for the Chobo League, no matter what. You can be the worst player in the world, you're still qualified. So the qualifying itself for BSL is irrelevant, but the qualification for the GOSU League is relevant for me. And if I did that, I'm not sure, because they are still waiting for confirmations of the players so that they know who will actually participate in the tournament and who will not. And depending on that, they will remove some people that do not confirm, and then I go up in the rankings and maybe qualify. I don't know that yet. I will know on Friday. I will stream on Friday, and I think by then I should know it. So that's the situation there. Okay, to be familiar. I think Iksukada. Wait. Congratulate. Chukahada. Okay, nice. Okay, yeah, enough reviewing. I think most words are in my head now. We have 650 words here, plus the 50 from here, so we are over 700 in total. And I even removed some of them here. But to be fair, I removed not really words, but only the letters and some words. So, yeah. But we are over 700, for sure. So, yeah, nice. Ah, here you have the full. But I don't think this is a full number, to be honest. I think I removed more than... this one is 707, and this one says 722, so the difference is 15. I think I removed more than 15 from this course, but I'm not sure, and it doesn't really matter. Time left to complete your daily goals. What's this, by the way? What's my daily goal? Maybe they should display my daily goal. Actually, you know what? Let's check that. Maybe in my settings. Oh no, I just leaked my email. Oh no, I just leaked my memorized registration date. No information about the daily amount I want to learn. But yeah, anyways. Okay, yeah, let's go to the website now. There we go. And now we will check out lesson 14. Korean passive verbs. Let's go. Introduction. Okay, wait, I have this. I don't know why I have this scene. Anyways, this lesson contains a lot of boring, confusing grammar, I'm warning you now. Yeah, we read that yesterday already. If you look at the vocabulary list, you have noticed something strange with some of the words. A lot of the words look similar to each other. The reason for this is because you will learn about passive verbs. Though, shouldn't this be although? I studied passive verbs very early in my studies. It is something that actually took me a year to fully grasp. Holy shit. And not because it is incredibly difficult, but rather because I never received any proper instruction regarding. Okay, so we can hope that we can understand it a bit quicker than 1 year. I don't really like explaining English grammar too much in my lessons. However, understanding of passive verbs, what passive verbs are and how they're used in English sentences will help you with your understanding of equivalent Korean sentences. Okay, active verb is used when a subject does an action. I eat, I learn, I open. Okay, so I know what active and passive verbs are. I know that. Active verbs, verbs often act on an object. Okay, I love my father. I want something and so on. I eat. Yeah. Okay, some active verbs cannot act on an object. I arrived at the park. So at the park here is not an object. At the park is just the place. Well, it is an object, but it's not the object that the verb is acting on, I would say. The park, not object, yeah, okay. The verb is not acting on that part of speech. Yeah, for example, I sleep as well. You can't say I sleep something, you know? You just sleep. It's not a verb that can... It's not an action that you're doing with some other thing. You're just sleeping yourself. And yeah. But then some other verbs, like I give you a book. So you give something. You give the book. The book is the object that gets acted on. Okay, so far that is all understood. Those are active verbs. The subject performs the action. Okay, active sentences. And now passive sentence indicates that action is performed on the subject. I was kicked. The door was opened. Okay. In English, passive verbs feel like adjectives. I was handsome. Yeah, okay, this is an adjective. It's the past form of to be. And here, yeah, passive verbs get constructed with the same word here, the past form of to be, which is was. So yeah, I can see that it's confusing, but yeah. Okay, here in this first sentence, I is the subject and we do an active action on the door, on the object, and here the subject is the door and it gets acted on. It was opened. The action to open was applied to the door. Okay. Below some more active passive part. Blah. Okay, well, this is all active passive in English. I think I have fairly good understanding of that. So I will skip through that a bit more quickly. The introduction alone is long enough. Okay. Yeah, so yeah, this part is maybe important. They cannot act on an object because they are an action that the subject gets acted on. So they are basically acting on the subject and not on an object. But you can still say by me to indicate who is actually actively doing the action. Okay. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, more examples. That's good. Because passive verbs cannot act on object, you will never see the object particle in a sentence predicated by a passive verb. Okay. This is probably the most important paragraph in this entire lesson. Okay. It is usually unnatural to use passive verbs in Korean. Okay, guys, that's it for this lesson. I think we can start with lesson 15 the next time. In almost every situation, it is more natural to use the active form of a verb. Instead of saying the house is built, it's more natural to say somebody built the house. Which implies that the house is now built. Okay. Yeah, this gets interesting if you want to indicate that a person is currently doing something. For example, he's right now building the house, so it's not completed yet. It's not built already, but it's in the process of getting built. So if you say someone built the house, if you have the past form here, then of course it implies the house is built. But if you want to say, yeah, I guess if you use the present form, someone builds the house. Yeah, okay, then it's not built already. Yeah, I guess, okay, I guess the difference between present and past tense of the verb is already enough for that. Okay, anyways, nonetheless, understanding how passive verbs are used in Korean is crucial to your development. Okay. There are many ways to make a passive sentence in Korean. This lesson we will look at different ways this can be done. Passive verbs are verbs, not adjectives. Korean learners often think they are adjectives because they look, sound, and feel similar to adjectives, and they never act on objects. Always remember, passive verbs are verbs. This is important because you must conjugate them as verbs and not adjectives. Okay. Okay, so let's dive into the first way to build passive sentences here. I've told you twice before, verbs ending in hada can usually be separated from hada to create a noun form of that verb. Yes. I worked. I did work. Yeah, we know that already. That's good. When dealing with hada verbs, most of the time you can simply exchange hada with dueda, dueda, to make the verb passive. Okay, that seems easy enough. Poam is, I think, to include. Yeah, okay, it's right next to it. Man, I'm really good at only reading a specific thing and don't look left and right of it. Okay. Poam hada. Poam dueda. Okay, and then we conjugate that. Poam let's say we conjugate this to past, okay? Past informal high respect. It would be, do yotsoyo? Do we yotsoyo? How do you conjugate that? There's like an O and then an E, and then you have the O from the past. I guess we'll see later. Okay. Jaegung hada. Jigong Dweda. Dweda, Dweda, Jigong Dweda. Okay, you can use passive verbs to create sentences that have similar meaning to sentences with each respective active verb. Structurally, the sentences will be different, however, because the passive version of a verb cannot act on object. Ah, okay. I definitely I definitely pronounced the sentence wrong. Structurally, the sentences will be different, however, because the passive version of a verb cannot act on an object. That would be more correct, I guess. Okay. So to summarize, yeah, I don't know, we just watched the examples here. This price includes tax. The tax is included. Yeah, I mean, that's a meaning of a sentence that is basically the same sentence, but one in active and one in passive form. It's obvious that the meaning is similar, right? You can't take the same word, same verb, as an active form and then just change it to passive and expect it to have a completely different meaning, right? It's for me it seems obvious. Maybe I'm not seeing something, but it seems obvious that this meaning is always similar. Okay, and that they will be different from the structure is also obvious because the noun that was previously the object is now the subject. So in this case we have text. Text is segem. So here to include this verb to include acts on the object segem. Here's the object particle, but this one, this object here, is now the subject. So it gets the subject particle, and then you have the verb in passive form with the dueda. Okay, here we have a possible conjugation. Dueda. Okay. Dueo, of course. Dueo. Dueo. Let us listen to that, but first of all I will read it one more time. Segmin poam dueo. Segmin poam dueo. 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 Segmin poam dueo.
세금은 포함돼요. 세금은 포함돼요.
돼요. 돼요.
세금은 포함돼요.
돼요. Okay. I prepared the lunch. I'm reading these sentences because I really need listening and speaking and reading practice. Because I'm very slow at that, so I want to do this. I prepared the lunch. 저는 점심을. Hello, Maros Akul. 안녕하세요. 저는 점심을 준비했어요. 준비했어요. 저는 점심을 준비했어요.
저는 점심을 준비했어요.
했어요. I always say 했어요. It's incorrect. It's 했어요. I know, I heard that Koreans also say 했어요. 요 sometimes. But it's more like casual. It's not Yeah, you can do it in a casual setting, but if you are speaking in a non-casual way, you always would say yo. So I really need to say yo and not yo. Okay, one more time. 저는 점심을 준비했어요. Okay, next one. The lunch was prepared. Here we have the change again. This time we have to, here we can see it's not fused together. It's not something like do your. I mean, it is do your, but if you speak it quickly, but it's not this your letter, the your letter itself. It's not here, this one. No, not this one. Do we have it here somewhere? No, we don't. Yeah, but you know what I mean. It's not, these two are not merged together. Often you see them merged together, but in this case, I guess it's not possible because this letter or this syllable is already ending in two vowels, and here this one is starting with vowel. You can't merge together three vowels, so I guess that's why it's separated. Or they just separated it here to make it easier to understand, and then in normal speech they are not separated. Anyways, here we have the lunch as a subject. 점심이 준비 되었어요. So this one, usually you would pronounce it as due, 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 due. But if there is a vowel following it, I'm wondering if you pronounce it as e here in the end. So like, duyosoyo, duyosoyo. Or is it just duyosoyo? Wasoyo, of course. We'll listen to it.
점심이 준비되었어요. 점심이 준비되었어요. 점심이 준비되었어요.
It's so quick. I can't understand it.
점심이 준비되었어요.
I think I don't hear an E. I think it's 도에였어요. 도에, 에, more like 에 and not E. It's 도에였어요. 도에였어요. In my opinion, that's what I hear. We'll check this one as well.
기계는 대체되었어. 기계는 대체되었어. 기계는 대체되었어. 기계는 대체되었어.
Ah, it's so hard to understand. It's crazy, man. Crazy. Yeah, but I think dueso.
기계는 대체되었어. 기계는 대체되었어.
도이었어? I'm not sure. Meros, I hear that too. Okay. Well, we will listen to a lot more of those. I think we'll get the feeling by the end of this lesson. Okay, adding o to, oh, he maybe here we have the explanation here. To dwe creates either. Okay, here this is what I mean. Here we have the merged form. Now I see. Now I understand this. Okay. See, this part, I think we had this one l yesterday for the can I pay by card too? Card do teo. Card do doeo. I think we had that, and now I actually understand that it's these two together. Okay. So I guess when speaking, they always just say this one. So this basically confirms the feeling that it's doe. doe, and not doyo. Doe. Yeah, okay, we'll see. Doe. Ah, here, this is the part that I mean. Either it's dweosoyo or dweota in this case, dweota, 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 or it's doeta. Okay, it's definitely a difference, a clear difference here. Sometimes you have two syllables, and it doesn't matter if you really separate them or you merge them together. The sound is basically the same, because if you speak the two syllables very fast, it's like they're one syllable anyways. But in this case, that's not the case. Here, it's for me, it's a clear difference here. Here it's dueotta, dueotta, and here it's just duetta, duet. 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 So, that's interesting. Often the speaker wants to indicate whom, by whom, or by what the lunch was prepared. By the school. Okay, now we learn that last part of a sentence, of a passive sentence. In the sentence above, although we are still using a passive verb, information about how the passive verb occurred is given. Yeah, but in these two sentences, yeah. This is an example of when it is much more common to use the active form over the passive form in Korean. In Korean, most likely in English as well, it would be much more natural to say I prepared the lunch and not the lunch was prepared by me. Yeah, I mean, yeah, that's he said that earlier already. It's clear. But we want to learn it anyways, of course. We always want to learn. In order to create the sentence, you need to remember that sentences with a predicating passive verb cannot have an object. Yes, we know that already. He's repeating himself sometimes, I have to say, which means you cannot attach R or IL, but nor. Thanks for following. Thank you. If you have any questions, just put them in the chat and I will read them and reply. Okay, you cannot attach R or IL to school or company. For example, the sentence below would be ridiculous and probably wouldn't be understood at all. Okay, let's try to understand it and translate it. So, jomshimi is lunch. Hakyo, hakyore is school as an object. And then we have a passive form, a passive past informal high respect form of to prepare. So it's the lunch was prepared school. Yeah. Yeah, it's exactly the same that we had earlier here as here. The door was opened me. This is incorrect. You have to say by me, and by me is not the object, it's something else. You can't put an object here. So this is this example basically. How are you today? Well, if you mean Flo, he already answered. If you mean me, I'm fine. I'm totally good. Hope you are good as well. Had some exams this week, but I still try to learn a bit Korean. That's good, Flo. Never find excuses to not learn. Well, I sometimes have excuses when I'm not streaming. For example, when I'm visiting my mother, who is not living in my city, so then I can't stream. So I think there are some valid excuses, but yeah, always try to not find them. Okay, let's continue here. It was understood by the students. Okay, wait, I'm too fast. I was here. In these types of sentences, in order to indicate how or by which means the passive verb occurs, you need to use different particles. Okay, so we don't use the object particle, we know that already. And now he's telling us which particle we should use instead to indicate the by. If this part of a sentence is a person, it is acceptable to attach the particle ego. No, wait. Ege. 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 We had ege already, right? Ege. 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 No, we had edehe. Edehe. We had edehe. But I think we didn't have ege, right? Wait, we did. We did. We did. Ege. It means and or with, right? Let me go back here. Lesson 13. Damn it. Where is it? Ege. Ege so. Ah, two. Okay, it means two. Ege. Okay, damn. The father gives money to his son. Aboginin adil ege tonil junda ege tu. Okay, okay, okay. So back to our passives. Okay, so if it's a person, we can put ege. So this usually means two. If we just like that for fun, if you want, we translate this as two. It was understood to the students. Ah, that doesn't really fit. So we have to accept that ege has really two different meanings. One is to, I give something to somebody, and the other one is by in passive sentences. Okay. Again, I highly suggest that you refrain from using this passive voice. This is a weird way to say this, in my opinion. From using this passive voice in Korean. It would feel more natural if he said you refrain from using these passive sentences in Korean. This passive voice, he makes it sound like I'm using the recording of this voice and use it somewhere else. I don't know. It's weird. I need you to understand that it's being introduced here so I can build on it for later lessons. The two sentences above would be better set as active variants, right?
집은 청소되었어. 집은 아버지에게 청소되었어.
집은 아버지에게 청소되었어.
집은 아버지에게 청소되었어.
네. It's here it sounds like she's just saying de. 청소되었어.
집은 아버지에게 청소되었어.
청소되었어. Let me
집은 아버지에게 청소되었어.
네.
청소되었어. 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 청소되었어.
Sounds like a 대 to me. 청소되었어. Uh, Wait, what are you talking about, guys? Wait, what? I have skipped some chat here. I think this year there are only 2 days I do nothing, and in average maybe around 20-30 minutes a day. Yeah, that's good. I think it doesn't really matter how much it is. I mean, of course, if it's only 5 minutes, then you barely learn anything, but it's more important that you're consistent and you're doing it all the time and not do 5 hours every 2 weeks or so. I think that's not good. If you do half an hour every day, it's way better because you have this consistent learning and you are used to learning Korean. You make it a habit. Okay, wow, that's crazy. Please make sure you look after yourself. Wait, what? 2 days. Meros Akul, are you saying that because Flo said that he only skipped Korean learning 2 days in the whole year? Yeah, it's pretty nice, actually. I definitely skipped more than 2 days already. I mean, okay, 1 week was because I was on vacation, but I think total I skipped 6 days so far in my 147 days. I skipped six. I had 6 days skipped in between that. Nadoyo Pabo. What is Pabo, Flo? I think I read Pabo earlier already. Or I read that before, but I don't know what it means. Pabo. Idiot. Okay. Yeah. As long as it's fun to me, I think it's okay. Some days are just sending a few voice messages to exchange partners. It's not... Oh, wow, this is actually interesting to me, Flo. I always wonder when for me the time comes where I should look for some language exchange partners to talk a bit. Just, yeah, as you said, some voice messages and so on. I feel like my Korean is definitely not at the point that I should do that because I need to think way too long. If I want to say a Korean full sentence, I stop after every syllable and have to think for 3 seconds, and I think that would be very annoying for a language exchange partner. But I'm wondering, when did you start, or how did you start as well? That would be interesting to me. Just try it. But for me, I stopped because it was too hard. Yeah, okay. So that basically confirms my feeling. Yeah, I have HelloTalk. I actually already downloaded it, but I'm not sure when the time is to start. Can you see it? HelloTalk, there it is. But now I can have small talk and it's beginning to be conversation. Okay, so you're saying that your level, it's starting to become useful. So you're just at the very beginning of your language exchange partner journey with your skill level. Okay, so since your skill level is quite a bit higher than my skill level, yeah, that means I still have to learn a bit more before I can start. A good thing is if you start talking to yourself. Hmm. I guess just speaking and reading and just practicing in general is always good, right? I have researched a bit a few days ago, and there was, I don't know what it was, where I heard it or saw it or read it, but the suggestion was you should also watch a lot of Korean videos, for example, but without subtitles, so you actually listen to a lot of Korean, and you can see a video with that, so you understand the situation, you understand what's going on in the scene, and you hear the Korean for it. You don't have the subtitles, you don't know exactly every word, but you know the general things, or you can like assume the things that are being said, and with that you get the feeling for the Korean language and you pick up more and more the more you do it, basically. You can build simple sentences already or start using Korean words for your to-do lists or notices. Yeah. I also tried to write every evening 3 sentences about what I have done this day. Yeah, okay, those are good suggestions. I guess that's to find topics about what to talk about or what to speak about or so. Yeah. I ate today at 1 o'clock. Okay, let me do it. Jeonin Onil. Okay, at 1 o'clock. I have to think about which numbers I use for which. I think Korean numbers for the hour and Chinese numbers for the minutes, but we don't have minutes, so it should be 하나 시레 먹었어요. Jeonin 오늘 하나 시레 먹었어요. Was that correct? I did say Hana. I did say Hana, and I said wait, I'm putting it in the chat. It's wrong already, I know it, but I said Hana Shire. That's what I said. But it's not she, it's she. Yeah. Yeah, you really have to repeat and do it more often to really improve at it. Yes. Practice always good. Okay, yeah, let's try to finish this chapter. Okay, it's very long still. Okay, so we should not use the passive sentences. We should use the active sentences. Because the passive sentences are very unnatural. Oh, and when it's a non-person, we just use a. Okay, that's interesting. So we have ege for person and only a for non-person. This seems quite easy. Jom shimi hakyoe junbi doeyasseoyo. Okay, the particle a. How do you pronounce this one again? Is it really ui, ui, ui? Or do you have some special pronunciation for this one? Or is it just a? Is it just a? Or is it ui? Yeah, there are really many uses of a. Ui. 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 It's Junglish time, or what is it? Yeah, Juglish. Wait, don't we have this word? 1 second. Righteous nation. What is foreigner again? Is it? I guess it's this. A man of great importance. this one, right? Okay, then this one is Dwe, Dwe, Dwe. Okay, now it all makes sense. It all makes sense. Okay, I think it's Ui then. Like for example, Uisa is doctor. Uisa, Uisa.
Uisa.
I feel like the ü is more, how do you say that, more prevalent compared to the E. The E is like almost not there, but the ü is very in the foreground, basically.
저는 의사입니다. 의사 중에서도 정신.
Yeah, okay. I don't know.
저는 의사입니다. 의사 중에서.
Yeah, it's ui, ui, ui. It's fine. Ui. Okay, back. The particle. If you speak this quickly, like it sounds like someone's trying to speak that is completely drunk and he's not really able to say certain things. E-U-I-H-E. Oh man. See? I always imagine me trying to speak to a Korean language exchange partner and I'm stumbling across my words there. I try to say that and I'm like he will just run away. Oh man. So can be attached to nouns that are non-people in these situations, but the distinction between e and e ui he isn't formally introduced until lesson 78. Since I'm advising against using the special form, it's best to focus on the current presentation and not skip ahead. However, I will definitely not skip ahead over 50 lessons. Yeah, okay. So, yeah, we'll just accept it as that. We have ege for person and we have e for non-person. That's all we remember so far. They would probably call an ambulance. Yeah. Also remember the meaning of euro. Okay, euro, before reading further, I think it was how something is done. For example, I'm going to Seoul by car. Or the house is made out of wood. So the means, the tool, the material of something. I think that was euro. Can be used to indicate, yeah, okay, nice. Okay, I remembered that one correctly at least. This means that you can say something like chonin chibil chong sogi oro chong so hesoyo. I cleaned the house with a vacuum cleaner. Okay, yeah, we have chong so twice in that sentence. Chong sogiro, chong so. Chong sogiro. Chongso has soil. Yeah. And the right. That was this one exception where you also can use that, and we didn't know in the workbook when we did the exercise in the workbook. That was really tricky. Yeah. But you wanted to say that sentence by using the passive verb. Okay, this one is the active one. So, I cleaned the house with a certain tool, the vacuum cleaner. And vacuum cleaner has the ro. But you can also say the passive form, the house was cleaned by the vacuum cleaner or by me with a vacuum cleaner. We'll see. If you want to say that sentence using passive verb to be cleaned, you would have to again use euro as a particle attached to chongsogi because it was the method tool that was used. House by vacuum cleaner was cleaned. Yeah, okay. Okay, so we cannot always remember e or ege for passive for the by. We always have to think, okay, is this the tool that was used? Is this a tool? Then we have to use ero or ro. But what else is there? In what situations would you use a then? Here. Lunch was provided by the school. Okay, yeah. Okay, so for like something like organizations and so on. Yeah, okay. But if it's a tool, if it's really a thing, then it's always like a tool or something, I would say. And then you always use row. Okay. I was driven to Seoul. Yeah, how do you say that? By my friend with a car? By car, by a friend? By my friend with his car? I have actually no idea. Yeah, it's weird if you have both in a sentence. If you want to say by someone with a certain tool, I guess you would just use both of them. Then you would use by someone is Ege, and with a certain tool is the Ro again. I think that's not a problem. Okay. Friend's car, Chingue, Cho, and Cha Donja. Wait, what? Ja don ja? I thought car is cha. Like Chingue cha. Cha. I only know cha as for car. Yeah, I know. By the way, I know friend's car, but I know this possessive particle, the car belonging to someone. I know this, but I mean, if you want to say, for example, the house was cleaned by me, but it was also cleaned by the vacuum cleaner. But I used it. It was cleaned by me with a vacuum cleaner. So in that case, you would probably use Ege. So by me is you use Ege because I'm a person. And then you use Ro for the tool that you did it with. Cha dong cha is automatic. Cha is used for many. Wait, they have different words for automatic and manual gear thing. Chonin vacuum cleaner Euro cleaned. Rang. No. The rang for with is if you have two nouns that are basically together, I think. Hago. Yeah. So to clarify that we are all speaking about the same thing and we don't misunderstand each other here, I'm putting the sentence in the chat here. I was driven to Seoul by my friend. By car, basically. This car. Okay, so this is the sentence that I mean. I was driven to Seoul by my friend, but the tool we used is the car. So I think this is actually not hard at all. I think it's... I will put the Korean in now. Chonin. Chonin Seoul by my friend Chowe Chowe Chingu 친구에게 Is this a double G or a single G? Single, okay. Yeah, you're right, Meros. We are going to Seoul. Ay, ay, ay. Wait, I will put the Korean in the chat soon, and then we can talk about it, okay? 친구에게 차로 You know what? We are just doing it this way. We are doing it this way. Bam! There we go. Here's my sentence at the bottom there. Okay? Here at the bottom you can see the sentence I have. So I have 저는 Seoul에 is definitely incorrect, as you mentioned. Maros are cool. That's incorrect. And then we have 저에 for my 친구에게 So by my friend. So the friend was the one doing the action of driving. Then we have 차로 by car. He used his car to do that. And now I just put the verb in the end, in a passive form, of course. So I have no idea what the passive form of to drive is, but we'll use the same. We used what we learned. Unjon doe. Unjon doe. Osoyo. Wow, made a mistake here. 1 second. Okay, so I have the sentence there. And yeah, you mentioned the particle of Seoul is incorrect. So, but are you sure the correct particle is Ro? I'm not sure about that. Let me go to this. Lesson 12. From and to. Now that was for time. I will go from Incheon to Seoul. Kaji. Can we use Kaji there? Sadly, it's not. Sorry, it's cut off and at the left side there, but I hope it's still fine. I will go from Incheon to Seoul. I think Ro is definitely correct, but I think Kaji is also correct, right? But let's use Ro to make it even more confusing, okay? Here we have. I will quickly switch to this one again. So here we have the Ro chapter. Here we have this the usage that we had already, and now we can see. Here this one is the interesting part. The other main meaning of Ro is to indicate the direction something's happening in. I will go in the direction of home. I will go home. Do you really use that for cities as well? Maybe. Let's use it. Okay, let's use it. So I have my sentence here in the bottom again. And I change the A of Seoul to Ro. Ro, I guess. Soure. Is it Ro? Sauro? Oh man. Kaji is when you're saying or referring to where you're coming from. From Incheon? No, from is Putor. Putor. Okay, wait. Let's first clear this part up. Here. Yeah, two soul. So Incheon is Putor. But two soul is Kaji in this case. Kaji, if the way is more important to you. Okay, here we have Aso for from, and here we have Putor as from, but that doesn't interest us. But we have Kaji for to Seoul in both cases. Kaji. But then, as we already saw, we have this part as well, where we have Ro. Chiburo. So I would actually say it's not Ro in this case that we want to have. We want to say I was driven to Seoul, right? So it doesn't really matter for us that we are going in that certain direction. We are just saying, okay, I'm in Seoul now and he drove me here. And the real direction is, I think, not important. I thought Kaji is when Putor is used. Okay, yeah. I would actually say it's really A, like it did in the first place. Okay, I have one more. I have one more source that we can use here. So we are already way over the time, but We will do this first. We will translate the sentence correctly before we stop today's stream. I'm opening something here. Meros are cool. You are seeing this the first time. This is a workbook from the website. And here we have, if I search that, to Seoul. We'll quickly find to Seoul. I went to Seoul with my dad, okay? So here, this is a good sentence, okay? This is good. I went to Seoul with my dad. This is, I think, a sentence that we can use. So here, what do we have? We have Ro. We actually have Ro. So, 1-0 for you, Meros. Okay, what else do we have? It only takes 2.5 hours to get from here to Seoul. So here we have from and to. So we have... where is it? Putor and Kaji. Okay, 2-0 for you, Meros. Here we have Kaji used only when Putor is used. So it looks like... Mero had the right answer with Ro. Yeah. Okay, so that's decided. We use Ro. So now here's my text block again. And Ro is in there. Ro. So Ro. So that means the sentence would read right now. Chonin. Sauro, Joe Chinguege, Charo, Unjon Due Osoyo. Okay. So is this sentence now correct or not? So the way we are going, the tool that we are using to go to Seoul is the car. So that's why I put Chado. But we are driven by the friend. So it's Ege for the friend. Oh, my internet's cutting out. That's bad, Maros. If you can hear me now, if you can watch the stream right now, I basically confirmed both of your statements. And also Flo as well confirmed it. So what you said is correct. We use Ro for Seoul and we use Kaji only when we have Puto. The delay is heavy now. I have no problems, to be honest, with my connection. All my data looks it's perfect, it's fine. So I'm not sure what's going on. Yeah, should be fine. You close the stream and reopen, it will reset the to current time flow. Yeah, that's a good idea. So we are all synced up. But must have been Twitch because my data says everything is fine on my end. Okay, so I hope you guys are back now and you're both watching the stream fine and you're both synced up. So the question again is that sentence now correct? Okay, Flo is still saying maybe the row for Seoul is not correct. So I did show Seoul. So I basically showed this part while you were gone, Maros. I went to Seoul with my dad, Jonin Aboji Rang, Seoul Ro. So this sentence here. But anyways, I would use A. Okay. Yeah, I mean, I used A in the beginning as well. Yeah. If we just had the native Korean now, right? Seoul Ro is the right form. Wait, you're saying I should not use the in the middle? Can make it a bit bigger, of course, as well, like this. And turn this off. Ah. Okay. Okay, here we go, guys. This is our task until the end of the stream. If you check the sentence about the dead, it's there too, as example. Wait, what? Sentence about the dead. That was this one here. We have. Yeah, we don't have the. Right, it's the other way around for this one. Okay, it's the other way around. You use Euro when you have a vowel in the end. and you use rho if you have a consonant in the end. In all other particles where you have two options, it's the other way around, but in this one, it's that one. Okay, obviously. So, we adjust our sentence here again. It was really hard to pronounce, I have to say that, so I'm thankful it's this one. But that would mean the charo I have in the later part should have it, right? Charo. Charo. Is that correct? Charo. Okay. So, what are we doing now? Is this the correct sentence or is it not? I'm not even sure if the English sentence is correct, to be honest. Oh man. Well, you could say with his car instead of by car. But I think by car is also a valid English sentence. By my friend, by car. Not sure, but anyways. Is the Korean sentence now correct, or is it not? What do you guys think? It's totally different, but my guess... Chonin... Ne. What is ne? Chingue. Wow. Chingue. Sawiro. I thought che is my of course you're using the low respect form, okay. Or the more informal. Yeah. Okay, I see. Yeah, I guess that doesn't really matter, right? That part. But what do you have then? Chingue. Chingue. Sowiro unjon hesoyo. Wait, are you just not using passive at all? The goal was to use a passive sentence here, to use a passive verb. Wait, you did. I. No, you did not use a passive verb. Wow, your sentence, I understand it as I drove in the direction of Seoul to my friend. That's what I understand from your sentence. Like, I'm going to my friend, not by my friend. I think... Wait, what? Ah, you probably just missed the gay, right? It should be a gay. A is confusing. I don't get it, but it was the lesson part. One second. Here we have lesson 14. Bam. Ah, here we have a summary. Ä to indicate something is occurred due to a non-person. Ege to here. Ege. I think it's Ege. No, it's the other way around. I think you mix it up there. Ege is for person and Ä is for non-person. Yeah, okay. So you just mix it up. It's fine. So then that part is at least the same that I have. Let's put your sentence in the chat again. So that was your sentence here. So the my is different. You use the informal one, but I think we can ignore that. And apart from that, you have not used the passive. And you have also not used the car. Yeah, okay. I think I will just ask like a Korean that I know. I think because we use the verb to drive, the car's implied. Yeah, okay, that's a good point, yeah. But I mean, that was the part that I... That was the point of the sentence. I wanted to have something where we have the by for the person that is doing the action. So the I was driven by my friend and the tool that we're using, by car. That was the point of the sentence, that we have both of them in one sentence. Maybe you have another good example sentence. I was killed by my friend by sword. You know? So, for to kill, it's not implied that you're using a sword. You could use a pistol, for example. So, if you're using the sentence, I was killed by my friend by sword, or with a sword, then we have the same sentence that I was going for, right? Okay. Yeah. I think we have it. I think we have it. It's Ege for the friend, and it's Ro for the car, and it's also Ro or E for soul. I think we can live with that. I think we can end this discussion. Chinguece. Caro. Caro. Is that an English loanword for car? Wait. Now I see the verb. It's to kill. To die. I died by my friend and car is sword. Okay. if you pronounce the R and not an L for that, it's car again. Oh man. Yeah, but I think this is to die, right? I was, is die also to kill? Like I was died by my friend. Is it I was killed by my friend? Let me see. Kill. Oh, well, that's not to kill. Ah, Jugida. Ah, yeah, Jugida, to kill. Was, and if we, wait, killed. Jugyo. Okay, guys, we are stopping the stream. Because to die is like an active verb, and to kill is already the passive form of to die. But then you have a passive form to kill for to kill as well. So it's like double passive because kill is like an implied passive form of to die already. Jesus. Does it happen with any other verbs? That you have a verb that is basically the passive of another verb, but it's active itself? Yeah, to kill is passive of to die. That's it. So, with that statement, we will end the stream. And yeah, we had a lot of overtime. but yeah, sometimes it's good to think about some stuff that you think about for yourself and not just read the lesson. So yeah, not sure if if the discussion helped a lot, but you still have to try. anyways, thanks a lot for watching, thanks a lot for participating and writing so much and giving your thoughts, and yeah, maybe see you tomorrow. Bye bye, annyeong.